While addressing the press on the forthcoming celebrations for the International Day of Swahili to be marked on 7th July, the Minister for East African Affairs, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, noted that Uganda is making positive strides in the popularization of Swahili as an official language.
Over the last 1 year, there has been renewed interest, and people who speak Swahili have come to my office. We have many Ugandans now who have PhDs in Swahili, and they studied here, both at Makerere, at the Islamic University of Uganda. We have a number of teachers.
Kadaga disclosed that by the end of this year, cabinet meetings will be able to be conducted in Kiswahili as more ministers continue to embrace the language. She explained that Swahili lessons are ongoing and they're going well in cabinet, with full hour reserved for learning the language whenever the cabinet sits.
My plan is to engage next day immigration officers, because they work at the borders with the population, the revenue people, because they always deal with people who are moving back and forth. All those who work at the borders will be my next target. And then we shall deal with the health workers, because they treat people, and so on. So all those that deal with the public, we shall work out a plan.
Kadaga has also called for a multi-sectoral approach to promoting Kiswahili language, with the Ministry of Education collaborating with other stakeholders. She has called for a census of Kiswahili teachers in the country to establish the national capacity to teach the language.
We were able to approve the National Swahili Council in the cabinet. So I think that one also will be put in place, but that will be under the Minister of Gender. So I think we are going to work together to scale up those efforts. About the recruitment, I think after we have launched this campaign, we should take a census. At all levels.
As government grapples with Kiswahili, Kadaga has also disclosed that the government plans to roll out the French language so that people can learn and make it compulsory for both primary and secondary schools.
Now, in the past, French was an optional subject. It was not necessarily examinable. So for the future, we shall have to make it compulsory, both at primary and at secondary level, and also probably at university. Equally with Swahili, my plan is that we should start taking Swahili at primary level, so it becomes the fifth subject at arithmetic, science, SST, English, and then we add Swahili.
Events to celebrate the International Day of Swahili in East Africa will be held in Uganda, and all member states are expected to attend, and speeches will be made in Kiswahili. But it is expected to be a humble event after it failed to attract any sponsorship.
We would get funders, so we had to cut down our program to just the symposium, but we think that that's a good beginning. And we hope that in the future we'll have bigger events. The theme of the event is Swahili and multilingualism, achieving more together. We shall have good messages from all the partner states, from all the seven partner states, and we're expecting ministers from all those states.
Kiswahili is the official language in Tanzania and Kenya, where it is spoken by the majority of the population. It is also widely spoken in Rwanda and Burundi. However, very few speak the language in Uganda, even though it is the country's second official national language after English. Kiswahili is being marketed as a bridging language in East Africa and used in trade. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.